Alright, so back in September, I made a video showing you guys how to assign a creative player to a team in NBA 2K20. Now, I've been looking through some of the comments on that video, and I see that a lot of people are still having trouble assigning their creative players to a team. And it's not just one or two people either. Every day I get multiple comments from people who are still confused on how everything works. So instead of going through and replying to each and every one of you guys, it'll be much easier if I just made a more clear and concise video. That way, if anyone still has any confusion or any questions, they can be directed to this video. So this time around, I'm gonna go a little slower, right? I'm gonna let you know which buttons you need to press for Xbox, which buttons you need to press for PlayStation, which menus you need to go to, and pretty much just give you more detailed instructions on how to get your creative players assigned to a team. So if this video does end up helping you, make sure to hit that like button, as that is always appreciated. All right, so the very first thing you need to do is create your player, right? So right now we're at the main menu. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna scroll all the way over to where it says features. Now, once we click that, we're gonna go over here to where it says create a player. And then of course, we're going to create our player. So I'm not gonna make you sit through this, but you get the idea, right? Change his name, choose his position, mess with the attributes, you know, make this player exactly how you'd like. And we want to make sure that we're getting all of that out of the way first. All right, so as you can see, I've done everything I wanted to do and I'm finished creating my player. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to scroll down and hit complete and then keep changes and return. And then here you can see my creative player shows up once we do that. Now, what we're going to do is back out of this menu. So on PlayStation, we're going to press circle, and on Xbox, we're going to press B. After that, we're going to select create roster, and then this menu is going to show up. Now, as you can see, there's three different options you can choose from. You can choose the official 2K Sports roster. If you have another roster you've already created, or maybe someone else created, you can choose the middle option. And then finally, if you want a roster where everyone is healthy and no one is injured, you can select the injury free roster. For the sake of this video, I'm going to select the official 2K Sports roster. Now, once we get to this menu, you're going to decide which team you want your player to be on. Now, me, I grew up watching Kobe. I'm a huge Lakers fan, so in this case, I'm going to choose the Lakers. So in this case, I'm using L1 and R1 to navigate through all the teams until I get to the Lakers. On Xbox, it's very similar. You'll just use LB and RB, or left bumper and right bumper, to scroll and go to whichever team you want your player to be on. Now, we don't want to use the triggers, because if we do, now we start getting into some of these menus, and that's not what we want right now. So make sure if you're on PlayStation, you're using L1 and R1, and if you're on Xbox, you're using left bumper and right bumper. Now, each team can have a maximum of 15 players. Now, in my case, the Lakers have 17 players on the team. Now, your team might be different than mine, so make sure that you're going through and counting how many players you currently have on that team. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove 3 players from the team, and what that does is that basically leaves me with 14 players, so that way when I assign my created player to the Lakers, he'll be the 15th and final member of that team. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just scroll all the way down to the bottom and select these bottom 3, and you can delete them from the roster if you want. I'm just gonna release them to free agency, so that way they're not deleted or anything. They're just not on the team anymore. So I'm gonna do that until I have 14 players on this particular team. All right, so now I have 14 players on my team. What I'm gonna do now is use L1 and R1 on PS4, or once again, left bumper and right bumper on Xbox, to navigate through all of these teams until I get to this section where it shows us all of our created players. Now, I know a lot of you guys were having trouble finding this menu last time, and you may have been using the triggers to navigate through the menus instead of L1 and R1, or left bumper and right bumper. A super easy way to find it is to scroll over to the 76ers and press L1 if you're on PS4, or left bumper if you're on Xbox. Press it once and it shows you all of the different players on that roster. And then if you press it again, it shows you all of your created players. Now, in my case, this is the only player I've created, so that's why this is the only one that shows up. But if you've created 5, 6, 7 players, all of them will show up on this screen. Now, once you get to this menu, what you're gonna do is select your created player and then go down to where it says copy to team. Now, once again, I chose the Lakers, so I'm gonna scroll down and select the Lakers, and then you'll get this message asking if you want to assign your created player to the team. And of course, we're going to say yes. Now, if we go back to the team we've selected, you can see here now that our player is on the team, but wait, do not leave yet. We're not done. Now we're going to use the triggers. So on PS4, I'm gonna press R2, and on Xbox, you'll press RT or right trigger, and this menu will pop up. Now, if we scroll all the way down, we see that the coach has no idea what he's doing because we have 0 minutes, right? That's not what we want. So what we're gonna do is simply select our player. And in my case, my player is a shooting guard. So we're gonna scroll up and select the shooting guard that's currently in the starting lineup. Now, once we do that, this menu is gonna pop up and we're gonna swap minutes and move players. So now, as you can see, our created player is now in the starting lineup. And if you wanna give him even more minutes, you can do that. Just take away someone else's minutes and put them on that player. Now, once all of that is finished, what we're gonna do is press circle on PS4 or B on Xbox and scroll down to where it says save roster. You're gonna select new file and you can name it whatever you want. Once again, I'm just gonna name mine created player for the sake of this video. Now, after that, you can simply go to the main menu and select my league or play now or wherever you wanna use this player. I'm gonna go over here to play now. And then at the bottom, you can see it says that I can pull up the rosters by clicking on the left stick. And this is the same for Xbox as well. So if I click on the left stick, we get these three options again. But this time around, we're going to select user created roster, and we're going to select the roster that we've just created. Now, if you scroll over to whichever team you selected, you should be able to see your created player there in the starting lineup, ready for you to play. Now, hopefully this video was a lot more clear than the last one, and I was able to answer a lot of your questions when it comes to assigning your creative players to a team in NBA 2K20. Now, if you guys still have any questions after this video, once again, feel free to leave them in the comment section down below, and I'll do my best to try to get some of those answered for you. Anyways, that is all I have for this video. If you guys enjoyed it, make sure you don't forget to hit that subscribe button and also turn on post notifications to know exactly when the next video is uploaded. All right, I'm out.